I have been really looking forward to talking about my new book, Guide to Fairyland. This is a huge encyclopedia of information related to everything connected with fairies and fairyland. There really could not be a more substantial guide to starting out with getting in touch with fairies and learning of their ways. If you want to connect with fairies and get into their land and explore fairyland, this could not be a better place for you to start. I'm just going to bring up the lighting a bit to show you clearer. So this is the beautiful cover, which was designed by Kedi Zasheva. Many will have seen the fairy emblem that I brought back, and she was able to translate it into this beautiful image. Anyone who is familiar with my first book back in 2019, Fairy Magic, it's actually 200 pages bigger than this one, so if you know the size of that one or you have this one, you have a general idea of how big this one is. So it has an extensive amount of information on everything related to fairies, and there's also over 50 color drawings and paintings and things like that in here. For example, I have all of the original fairy artwork that I had done back when I first started connecting with fairies, and so there's a lot of these beautiful images inside the book of these beings that I met in the fairy worlds, and they can be seen in this book. And then there's also basically my entire first 8-week beginner's guide to Fairyland course is in here in transcribed form. So anyone that is familiar with that video series that I had online for quite some time, and you can still see it at my website, that takes up that much of the first part of the book. And then that is followed by a 12-day course on clairvoyance, on developing clairvoyance. So the first part of the book is split up into the different weeks. So for 8 weeks, you basically go through this whole beginner's guide into learning all about fairies and how to contact them. Then it goes into the 12-day course on developing clairvoyance. So that really enhances your visionary abilities and things like this, and basically is split up into the different days. So after 12 days of working through that, then you will be prepared to start the 22 fairy lesson section. So basically the whole book is kind of set from beginners to advanced and just keeps getting more and more advanced as it goes. And the 22 fairy lessons is basically like lessons in magic and witchcraft, like fairy magic basically. 22 fairy lessons here, and it has a lot of information here, and I was really happy because there's been a lot of witches and wizards and magicians and things that I have really admired over the years, and I was able to actually get in touch with several of them and ask if I could include some of their practices in here, and I had a very positive response from a lot of people. And so there's a lot of very beautiful information in here, and it teaches you a lot of things. Here's one of the diagrams of one of the magical ritual practices to call up the elementals and things like this. There's a lot of really beautiful information in here. There's one that talks about how to create your own sort of talisman to help bring certain desires and wishes into your life. And there's also a lot of information on the planetary squares, which are these very magical mathematical formulas connected to the archangels of the planets, and you can basically use them for different purposes, and I teach about that in here and how you can use them, and they're extremely powerful. When I first wrote these out, I was sitting inside of a circle, and you basically have to fill out these very particular numbers for each of the planets. Like this one here is for Jupiter, for example, and it has these very specific number formulas that are in here. And I left a couple of them unwritten because it really activates them once you write them out. And so I was charging everything up and calling all this energy in, and then I added in the last couple of numbers that I'd left out to sort of activate the square. And right in front of my eyes, a whole aura around the square, about that much, just appeared in color right around the whole thing. It was like out of a movie, just like shoo. And I couldn't believe my eyes. It really was just this most amazing experience. And I had a lot of things like that. Like when I was in those circles doing some of these spells, I had all these lights and everything. I was using candlelight, but I also had these other lights that were nearby. And I would face each of the different directions that were connected to the elements. So I was going, working through them much like the seasons. And then when I faced north, which is the one associated with winter or death or darkness, as soon as I faced that direction, all of the lights just went out on their own. And after I had got out of the circle, I went over to check like what had happened, and the switch was actually switched off. But I have no doubt in my mind that the lights were on for the entire rest of that ritual. So it was a very strange thing. And I also started receiving different cuts and things on my skin while I was facing the fire direction, which is associated with the knife. So there were a lot of strange things like that happening. But of course, it's probably not the best thing to be going into all that stuff, like when I'm just talking about this book. But basically, the first half of the book is very much like beginner's information, really starting out, and you can decide how far you want to take that. But basically, the book enables you to keep taking that further and further and actually learning real fairy magic practices and developing these energy practices that enable you to really produce quite powerful results in the world. And so that goes through 22 of those lessons, all about that. And there's also information in there about connecting with extraterrestrials as well and seeing light ships, all of that stuff. It's very, very extensive information. And then once you get through there, which also contains a couple of video transcripts and things that I had done, then it goes to the Mystery of the Primrose section, which is a short 35-page text, which it's the first time it's ever been published here. This is the original symbol here. Hang on, I'm just going to change the lighting again. That's the original symbol that this one here was based on. So the this book talks all about the mysteries and secrets and information of the primrose flower, which is that flower. Took that picture one night when they first started to bloom. And they're a really magical flower, and I talk about how you can grow them in here, and I talk about their symbolism and what they mean and so forth. There was a documentary that I made on them a little while ago, which I don't think is online anymore, but this book is very much connected with that. And then towards the end of that, there is a fairy alphabet and script. So at the end of that section, I actually have the original drawings of the... I have to cover this part up, but this was like the original language and alphabet system connected to the English alphabet that I included in there, and there's a digital version in there too, so you would be able to write in the fairy alphabet if you have this book. And you can actually write in that script, which you can see all around here, and you'll be able to understand what's written around there, and you'll be able to write your own letters or poems and things like that in that alphabet, and it can really help to call in the fairy energies. Then there's a section on the Songbook of Fairyland. So this is all of the music that I've brought back from Fairyland. I have 22 songs on the Lost Enchanters 1, 2, and 3 that is included in here. And it has all of the lyrics and where you put the capo on the guitar and all of the guitar chords along with all the different songs. And so it's a very, very beautiful section at the end of the book there where you can actually play along to any of the music that I have recorded on those Lost Enchanters albums, and all of the lyrics and chords are right there for you to work with. So that's a really exciting part of the book, because these are songs that I really brought back from Fairyland. Here's one of my favorite ones off the new album, The Fairy Ring. And it tells you like which fairy wrote them and all of that kind of stuff, and goes into more information on that. And then there's also these appendices at the back, which includes some biographies of people connected with Fairyland as well as a map of Fairyland. So this biography is about Opal, who I talk about in the Beginner's Guide to Fairyland course. And she's the one that has inspired many people that have taken that course to seek out the joyous blue, the blue flower. This is when I went to visit Opal's hometown, and it was a really beautiful experience to actually go there and experience what that would have been like in the place where she grew up. And then this section, for example, is on Fiona McLeod. I love what it says up here, which is, "Those who go in search of the fount of youth are the dreamers and the children of dreams, and these are not many, and few come to this lonely place." This information really is available here in this modern world. I have compiled everything together and put it into this one book so that others can pursue and find out more about this and actually learn to get in touch with fairies. In the back of the book, I have an ancient map of Fairyland section, which does not include the entire map, but I made a video recently which was really about all of the different locations that I have visited in my journeys to the fairy worlds. And when I go to the fairy worlds, I go through the different elements of fire, air, water, and earth, each of which is like a different section of the fairy worlds. And that is how I wrote these four elemental books of earth, water, air, and fire. I wrote them in the other order to that. And those books represent or summarize a 40-day journey that I took into the fairy worlds. And then after I had taken that journey, I discovered a guide to the map of Fairyland and a map of Fairyland that had been drawn many, many years ago. And I was stunned to find out that all of the places that were drawn on the map corresponded to the books that I had just written. And there were like very specific details and locations that I had visited, and I understood how to navigate the entire map and where everything on the map was and what it all meant, because I had just come back from that same place. And so I have included some pictures from that map in this book. Like, for example, this is the Fairy Queen's castle, which here is called Oberon's Palace. And I basically have included a couple of excerpts from those elemental books next to the pictures to explain what they are. So this one's from the Water Realms, and it has some pictures from there, and then it has some quotes from those elemental books explaining a little bit more deeper information. I couldn't put the entire map in there because it's a gigantic map. It's truly massive, but I hope to get it printed out someday and just have it around me all the time, because it's so accurate to how the worlds work there. But I wanted to include many of the pictures in here so that you can get a taste for it, and you can go and find the map online for free as well. And as I said, you can find a lot more information about those locations in these different books, the Book of Water, Earth, Air, and Fire. And I've also recently completed the Book of Hermes as well, and there is a section in here about the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn as well, and goes into deeper background information about all of that. But the Book of Hermes is the one I just finished before this one. I have books appearing everywhere from every direction. It's been absolutely insane, but I've just been flooded with information. Ever since I got in touch with fairies, I have been so excited about the things that I'm discovering that I just really want to share them and write them down and put them everywhere. But this book in particular has been the most rewarding for me. It's the one I've been really working on for years, like 7 or 8 years, if you're going back through all those courses and everything. This is a compilation of information that has taken me right from the earliest stages all the way through to where I am now. And I actually cried upon completing this book because of the weight that was suddenly lifted from me to have it all in one place, finally, to have completed this book. Out of all the books that I have written, this is the one that really summarizes everything into one place. And I feel that this book can lead anybody into communication with fairies and into accessing Fairyland in a most powerful way. And it has such deep information, such deep magical information. And so I've written here in the start, it is a collection of fairy lessons, courses, books, art, and music. And as I said, it's 577 pages. I'm selling it for $55. As I said, there is over 50 color pictures and artwork. I think it's more like 70 or something, but it's at least 50. So there's a lot of the beautiful pictures and paintings and photographs and things in there. And in the introduction, I talk about what each of the sections is. A really important thing about this book is it's very practical. The entire thing is very down to earth and just has exercises throughout the whole thing, like try this, try this, try this, so that you can directly experience these things for yourself. So there's no need to try and believe what I'm saying or wonder, is that true, is that not? You just simply follow the practices and you will find the results. So it says day 6 of this course, the clairvoyance one, also contains rare and detailed information about real human giants, including several artistic impressions that are based on documented experiences with them from the 1700s, which was honestly one of the most fascinating things for me, because in fairy magic, I do talk a little about the giants. And that was because when I initially did this practice in that course on clairvoyance, it was for summoning up memories from the earth, and that's when I first came across these giants that had existed in my hometown. And then many years later, actually while I was writing this book, I was going back over all of the practices because I wanted to make sure that everything was as effective as possible and refine anything that needed refining and so forth. And so I was doing that same practice again, trying to call up memories from the earth, not intending on finding out more about the giants, but just simply trying to gather memories from the earth. And I was down at the beach and I was calling up these different memories, and I saw this vision of a being, of a man that looked as if he was wearing clothes from a completely different era, such as the 1700s. He had this really big hat on, and there was also a white feather pen that he had. And he was writing a book. And then I was given the name Byron, or Byron. It was like B-Y-R-O-N, just capital letters in my head. And then I woke up out of the trance. And I was like, at first I just thought I must be just thinking of Lord Byron and didn't think too much of it. But I thought, well, I'll look it up just in case there does happen to be some kind of connection with this Byron figure and the things that I had seen. So through one thing or another from the visions that I had been seeing, it basically led me to a book, which is now thousands of dollars to find anywhere. And I managed to trace this book down and gather all of the excerpts about it, but it actually had real pictures of these real human giants that were discovered back in the 1700s. And I've included these pictures in this book. Now these, even in the time when the book was actually written in the 1700s, I think the second edition of the book, they had actually already removed those images from the book, and they had actually gone and altered the heights that they had written down about the giants in there. But when you read it all in context, it becomes very evident that the first edition, none of the things in there would have made sense if all of those had been wrong, as they suggested. And so I basically went deep into this topic and learned all about these giants. And I have included every excerpt from that book, which is extremely rare and hard to find now. But I went through and I read the entire book, and I found every little section in there where it mentioned anything about these giants, information about them, what kind of beings they were, and different things that they had learned. And I excerpted every part of that and I put it into this book. So this is a way of immortalizing some of that information, which had been lost to time, and I only knew about it through going into those visions again. And I teach methods in this course on how you can summon these kinds of memories to you as well and gather that kind of information. That's just one example of many. But yeah, the book is, I don't know what else to say about it. There is also some really beautiful artwork in here from George William Russell, like some of those beautiful paintings which really call up a lot of energies of the fairies. And I've got some pictures in there from some of the videos, for example, me with the squirrel, when I'm talking about how you can summon some animal guides to you. So I've got a lot of information in here that will take you through everything that you need to know about fairies and fairyland. There could not be a more extensive book to start with. There's enough information in here to work on for years. If that is something which is of interest to you and you would like to get this book, as I said, it's $55 US. That includes the shipping. And you can basically obtain it by emailing me at jeremygarner11@gmail.com and letting me know that you're interested. And I just receive payments through PayPal to that same email address. And then I will have it shipped out to you from a company in the US. And then you will have this book. As I've written in the introduction, you now have in this book a complete set of practical exercises through which you can personally learn to contact fairies and directly communicate with the many and mysterious inhabitants of Fairyland. So if you would like to obtain this book, let me know. If you would like to get some of my earlier books, such as Fairy Magic, these go deeper into topics that are not covered in this one. So these books definitely still work together. I have a lot of techniques in this one that I have not gone into in this one. And I also have the Book of Hermes, which is a shorter book that I have done recently. There's another video on that if you want to learn about these things. On the books section of Sky Gloria, you can go and read all of the blurbs, see the pictures, and there's also a section on there where you can watch me talking about every one of the books that I have written. So I have those ones, and then as I said, I also have the Four Elemental books, I also have the hardcover Divine Union books, which are over there, but that's like 1400 pages of journal information of my interactions with a spirit in 2014. Thank you so much for watching this video and taking the time to listen to me talk about this. If it is of interest to you, then get in touch with me and I will be very excited to get this book to you. I don't use social media a whole lot, as most people will probably know by now, so I'm really relying on word of mouth to promote this book. So if you get this book and you really like it, please share it with your friends, tell people, you know, direct people that you feel would really resonate with this type of information and would treat it as sacred. Direct them to me and I would be more than happy to help them to access the fairy worlds. This information is really important to me, but I don't want to just necessarily scatter it all over the platforms that are there myself. But I would be really happy if it's something that touches you and you want to share it with other people and let them know that it exists, then that's totally cool, especially with this one. This one feels much more just accessible to everybody, really, because it starts out from the earliest stages and sort of slowly guides you into these realms. Come to skygloria.com, thelostenchanters.com, aquarianrevolution.com. That's where I live, really, in these different realms, but where you can really find me is in these hidden dimensions amongst the fairy people. And if you would like to join me there, get this book, and I will look forward to seeing you there too.